Welcome to today's lecture. Today we will be studying about the pectoralis minor muscle. So in this slide, what you can see here, this is the pectoralis minor muscle. So this pectoralis minor muscle, it is a thin, flat and triangular shaped muscle which lies deep to the pectoralis major muscle. So here the pectoralis major muscle is reflected, then you are seeing the pectoralis minor muscle. Then few bony landmarks what you are seeing here. So this is the clavicle, this is the acromion. So this is acromion and this is the coracoid process. So these two are parts of the scapula. So related to this pectoralis minor muscle, we are supposed to know this coracoid process clearly. So this coracoid process along with this pectoralis minor muscle, so this pectoralis minor muscle is inserted to this coracoid process. So this coracoid process along with pectoralis minor muscle, they form an osseomuscular bridge under which the axillary artery, axillary vein and the brachial plexus is passing through it. So this pectoralis minor muscle, when it is attached to this coracoid process, below it is the osseomuscular bridge through which all these structures pass. In this slide, what you can see, this is the axillary artery. So this axillary artery is subdivided into three parts by this pectoralis minor muscle. So this pectoralis minor muscle is dividing the axillary artery into first part, which is lying above this muscle, then the second part which is lying behind this muscle, and the third part which is lying below the muscle. So this pectoralis minor muscle is dividing the axillary artery into first part, second part and the third part. So in this picture you can see a section. So this is the superficial aspect, this is the deep aspect. So in the superficial aspect only you are having this pectoralis major muscle. Below the pectoralis major muscle you are having the pectoralis minor muscle. The upper border of this pectoralis minor muscle gives attachment to the clavipectoral fascia. And here you will have one artery which is related, and that is the superior thoracic artery. Then the lower border of the muscle gives attachment to the suspensory ligament of axilla. And here it is accompanied by the lateral thoracic artery. Now coming to the origin of this pectoralis minor muscle. So it arises from the third, fourth and fifth rib near the costal cartilages. It also arises from the fascia covering the external intercostal muscle. So in between these ribs there is the intercostal muscles, so covering it there will be the fascia. So the origin is from the third, fourth and fifth ribs and also from the fascia covering the external intercostal muscles. Now coming to the direction of this fibers, the fibers of the pectoralis minor muscle, they run upwards and laterally and they converge to form a short flat tendon. You can see all these fibers are running upwards and laterally and they are forming a short flat tendon which is getting inserted to the coracoid process. Now coming to the insertion, it is inserted into the medial border and upper surface of the coracoid process of the scapula. So this is a coracoid process of scapula. All these fibers, they unite to form a short tendon, and this tendon is getting inserted into the medial border and the upper surface of the coracoid process of the scapula. Now coming to the nerve supply of the pectoralis minor muscle. The pectoralis minor muscle is supplied by the medial pectoral nerve as well as the lateral pectoral nerve. Now coming to the actions, the pectoralis minor muscle will assist the serratus anterior muscle in pushing the scapula forwards, that is anteriorly, that is the protraction of the scapula, which helps a role during the punching movements. It also depresses the shoulder. The pectoralis minor muscle is considered as the key muscle of the axilla. It is because the pectoralis minor muscle crosses the axillary artery and divides it into three parts. The origin of the pectoralis minor muscle is variable. It is called as prefixed when the fibers arise from the second to fifth ribs, whereas it is called as postfixed when the fibers arise from the fourth to sixth rib. Coming to clinical importance, the pectoralis minor muscle acts as a landmark in certain surgeries, to identify the axillary lymph nodes during mastectomy when there is cancer and for the removal of the breast. So here the pectoralis minor will play a role as the landmark, so the surgeons can trace and remove the lymph nodes around it. Thank you for watching.